What's up?
Oh, you can't see the clock. You can't see the clock.
You don't need to see that.
Oi, let's go move this over there.
Can you see the clock?
You don't see the clock. Why so important? Not very.
You would think I would have messed with that beforehand, right? What time is it?
You know what time it is?
It's I can't fucking sleep time. That's what time it is. Ooh, I ain't got nothing to drink. Shit. All right, hold on. That space heater is, it's better than the wall heater as far as humidity is concerned, but it still dries out the air. I mean, all the freaking heat. I mean, it was just a couple of videos ago. It was only fucking 70 degrees, right? Now it's like 30. I'm blowing air out because I need circulation, fresh air. So, it says it's 36 degrees there. I bet you if I went outside and I turned on the truck, it would say, yeah, buddy, I think it's like 28 right now. I'm like, whew, okay. What the fuck is going on? What are you doing? What's the good word? This is a great guitar for frickin' like metal. You know what I mean? Name that tune. Name it. Name it. Ha ha. I don't even remember why the hell I started playing that. Oh. I got nothing better to do. I'll forget. I can't sleep. I didn't start out that way. I was like, you know, I was ready to crash out like earlier. And all of a sudden, I just woke up. I had a cup of coffee. But I was freaking, I got wired. I mean, my friend was in the hospital with a kid and everything like that. And so I was just freaking hanging out and, you know, being there, you know, and whatnot. And waiting for, you know, results to come back and forth and trying to keep her right out there. Trying to be there. Trying to, you know, throw some funny shit and, you know, keep it light. We didn't know what was going on. Everything was freaking, I mean, you know, you don't want your kids sick. You never want your fucking kids sick, right? So the little one was in pain and everything like that. I think I said something in the last video. And, you know, it was fine. I mean, I felt myself zonking out and then all of a sudden, I'm like, oh shit, I'm up. So, I'm going online and I'm looking at Guitar Center Used. So I went to Guitar Center Used, I went to the amp section, I went to the tube section, and I went to the budget section, you know, because I'm not going to freaking pay a whole lot of freaking shit. So I wanted to see what was, you know, what was you know, marginally okay between freaking 300 and 500. And I'm looking at the stuff and I'm like, yeah, let's see what's going on between 2 and 300. Because, you know, once the freaking, once this season passes, I'll be able to freaking put a few dollars together again and pick something up in like 2 months or whatever. You know, it's, nah, I can swing 100 here and 100 there, but freaking, I have this friend who like, she's like my daughter, you know, I mean, every time you turn around, you know, it's like, Dad, I'm like, if I got it, you gotta catch me when I got it, cause it goes fast. But half the time, my daughter, she don't freaking catch me like that. She likes to freaking come up and say, oh, I need $1,000. I'm like, good fucking luck, child. And she's in her 20s. I'm like, I didn't do that when I was in my 20s. I was like, the most was like freaking 50 here, you know, 100 there. Not even. I mean, before I got clean, I was out there. I was dealing. And then I was doing stupid shit. So, and then I got clean and then it was all over. I just started freaking working and that was the end of that, you know. So, in the video before this, I was testing to see if this thing was going to come up with those storms, static storm, and it came out, you know, it didn't come out bad. There was nothing going on, and right now we're still in the middle of a freaking storm. We're at a magnetic thing of 4 right now, and I wouldn't doubt it would go higher, because it's still like freaking out a bit. I showed you the thing, right? So we're still at it like a 4 or so. And so I was looking at this thing and I said that I cleaned it up, that I was gonna get a false positive. I wouldn't know whether it was this unit or if it was the storms contributing to it or a combination of the both. You know, and since we were in the middle of the storm since the last time I freaking ran the recorder, and it didn't come, excuse me, and it didn't come anything, it didn't get any, it didn't pick up any freaking, or generate any static. It's hard to freaking tell, you know. Why was I thinking of this? Oh yeah, so getting back to, you know, the bullshit that I was keeping myself occupied, you know, because, you know, I'm looking at a couple of things. I don't know. I mean, these small amplifiers are awesome looking, right? Because I was watching Andy Tibbins do a demonstration of the Mark 25. I can't afford a Mesa, but it would be nice, right? So that's what I was trying to do originally, was trying to see if I could find one cheap, you know, on the cheap, a Mesa. Cheap. They have them, but what is it? It's a Roadster, I believe it is. Not too bad. They go between around freaking between 5 and 800. It's not too bad. Used, right? But I don't need a combo. And all the Roadsters, that's what they are. They're combos. Sound great. And they're pure metal. You know what I mean? So I'm flipping through. And I find this goddamn thing called a Marshall. A Marshall, oh yeah, so I had scaled down my freaking, my budget search to 200 to 300. I was like, let's keep something a little bit more freaking, you know, that you can get sooner. instead of saving up. So I was like, all right. So, you know, between 200 and 300, I can get within like 2 or 3 months. That's not bad. I can swing that in like 2 or 3 months. So I was looking at the Windsors. You know, the word's been out. The word got out. And freaking, you know, the Windsors are like freaking starting to become, the PV Windsors are starting to become hard to find. I'll get back to the Marshall in a minute. But the Valve Kings are still hanging in there at around 2 and change. And they seem to be plentiful. You seem to be able to get them no problem. And I don't think they sound very bad. I really don't think they sound bad at all. As a matter of fact, I think they sound awesome. You know, the only thing is, it's a lot, you know, for regular maintenance, because of what is it? There are 100 watt heads. So if you're going with a 100 watt head, it's not like, you know, a 60 watt or a 50 or whatever, because you're gonna have four. I think you have five preamp tubes, because you got multiple channels, right? You got 5 preamp tubes and you have four power tubes. So, I mean, you're looking at almost fucking $200 worth of fucking tubes, $250 worth of fucking tubes alone. You know what I'm saying? So it gets up there. So if you get these things and you go to check out the BIOS and everything like that and they're down, you're going to need new tubes. And you're going to pay almost as much as you did for the freaking amp as you do for the tubes. So, like, things to consider. And it's a consumable, you know, no matter what. I mean, it depends on what you're doing and how often you play it and shit like that. Some tubes will last forever. If you're not gigging like all the time, like some people, if you're gigging all the time and you're really cranking out, banging out, you'll be changing your tubes. Like from what I've read on the forums, every 6 months. That's not uncommon. But from what I've read, but if you're just like, you know, bedroom freaking hobbyist or whatever and shit like that, and practicing and whatever, shit's will last you forever. So. Jeez, I was thinking about getting just a couple of fucking valve states. The 250. Imagine, can you imagine? Instead of spending $700, I think, Robert, we had this conversation, right? He's like, dude, why don't you just sell like 3 or 4 of your freaking guitars and get a nice fucking $1,000 guitar? I'm like, it's a good idea. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that reasoning at all. Whatsoever. I mean, he's got a point. But, I'm already up there, so it's like, now it's a matter of, I'm already at, like, freaking critical mass when it comes to, like, freaking space. So, the only thing I would be thinking about is freaking replacing this one. Because I don't really see freaking keeping it. You know what I mean? I mean, I really don't see keeping it. I mean, at some point in time, I might play around and get another mic, get an AB switch, and play the shit through the whole complement, you know, and then, you know, AB one amp, and then this amp through these cabinets, and see what that sounds like. You know, do one clean with a little bit of reverb or whatever, and or delay, and do the other one dirty. That should sound nice. I think that should sound nice. But like I said, I'm hitting critical mass, so my desires are going to be very humble, right? So I would not think about getting like freaking huge cabinets or even freaking combos. I cannot freaking. I put together combos just so I can, and built a combo just so I can have my you know, family come over and play it all together. But they don't come up. I mean, they're not going to be coming up like it. I don't know. We're 3 hours away, I mean, from my family, so it's it's a little tough. it's easier up here. I mean, it's easier up here. You get up here, there's like no fucking traffic, but you go back down to the city in Long Island, and it's like, blah, why? Why? And my sister just asked me if we were going to come out there for Thanksgiving, and I'm like, I don't think so. We'll see. If the weather's for shit, then I'm not going to take an 8-hour drive, but if the weather holds up like it looks like it has been and will, and I'm surprised too. We really haven't gotten like no fucking nor'easters. None. And this is nor'easter season. When we get fucking hammered in November, October and November. We're due for like a freaking, at least a 1 foot freaking dump of snow. And we've got nothing. It was just 70 degrees. I mean, now it's like freaking 28 degrees now. But they're still calling for like 30-something degrees all freaking, you know, for the next 3 weeks. Like, I don't know. I don't know. Anything can fucking happen. So we're playing it by ear. And see what's up with that. You know, other than outside of that, you know, it's just... I don't know. So I'm watching the reviews. I'm like, all right, Valve King. Okay, Valve King, nice. To get like fucking three, just fuck it, just, you know, because if someone needs one, I got one. To get, you know, spend like $750 or whatever and freaking get three Valve Kings. What do you need three Valve Kings for? In case someone needs one. And they're not available. It's like the Windsor. I've only found like freaking two Windsors on there. And this goes national. So it looks all over the place for the damn things. It used to be, like I said, it used to be that you can be able to get them no problem. So people getting smart, right? They fucking pick up the goddamn things. Because they're great amps. They're perfect workhorses, and they're inexpensive. So that you know, so if something happens to them, you just get another one, right? Which I can understand. So, like the Valve King was going to be the next thing, you know, the next thing that comes out. I see, because it's a lot more available than the Windsor. I mean, I've come across like six of them so far, and they're 100 freaking waters. So I wanted to see what was the available. So the HT5, the Blackstar HT5, nice freaking compact little unit, right? Does the job. Plays fucking nice, has great fucking tone and everything like that. Nobody's got a complaint about it. So I'll be eyeballing that. I just started, so I wanted to see what the deal was, because all of a sudden I come across this Marshall that I have never fucking seen. Pixie had said something the other day. Everybody was asking him questions and everything like that on his live video. And someone asked him about, you know, which Marshall would he go after. And he said some freaking thing 410. So, oh, the JVM 410. Well, it's a Joe Satriani model. So, of course, that's like freaking, like 1600. I think it was the cheapest that I seen it for, maybe 11 and change, maybe. But I'm like, what? But he shreds, you know, he's a monster. Pixie, that is. So I'm like, okay, I can understand that. And then, so I looked at that, and I was like, I don't know. That's a whole lot of amp for just fucking playing around. That's like this. It's like, this is like freaking way more than I'll ever freaking use. And so I see this thing that looks like a 410. Has almost as many as freaking many knobs. And I'm like, what the hell is this? So I'm watching review after review after review. I mean, I'll go onto YouTube and it's within the 200 to 300 mark. I'm like, wow, that's fairly inexpensive. Does it have tubes or what the fuck is the story with it? Is it all digital? Because if it's all digital, I don't want it. I had enough of all digital. So it looks like it's a fucking hybrid. It looks like it has tubes and digital effects and shit going on. It's got a little freaking pedal on and whatever. And, you know, it has all kinds of freaking things going on. So I'm looking at the reviews, and usually, you know, you see something like from Sweetwater or from, like, you know, Pro Guitar Shops or freaking somebody, you know, who gives you a whole fucking rundown. Ain't nobody got shit that I've seen so far on YouTube in regards to reviewing this goddamn amplifier, except for individuals. So I'm watching everybody do it, and then, you know, they're all going from jazz to freaking, you know, to shredding. And I'm like, wow, you know, okay, tell me more, you know. Nobody's really giving you any freaking thing. I mean, some people. I am so. At this standard, looking at all of those videos of these guys freaking doing their reviews and everything like that, I'm like, I don't feel bad today. Comes to playing, I don't feel bad. When it comes to like the production, you know, because I do like a one stop. You know, very rarely do you see me freaking hit it. You know, see me hit the stop and freaking come back. I do it all one. I try to do it all one run. But, you know, with that being said, you know, I also do, I try to freaking do the best I can with the sound quality and stuff like that, because it just, this is how I feel. If you're willing to give me your time, I should be willing to give you the best quality that, you know, you should be able to enjoy the experience, because, you know, I'm just bullshitting, you know, and really, if you, I can identify with me and you freaking, you know, that's really it. You know what I mean? Otherwise, you know, click and you're out of here. So, and I can't blame you for that, because I wouldn't want to freaking watch something like that I couldn't freaking get into. So, I'm watching all these videos, and I'm like, God damn, man, people, seriously? And then I was like sitting there, and I'm like, you're playing the goddamn thing, and you're demoing it for other people. But the sound of your fucking amplifier, the sound that you're freaking producing, sounds like you're inside a 5-gallon jug. I don't care what you're fucking playing. I don't care how you're fucking playing. I don't care how good you are. I really don't care how good the amplifier sounds, because it doesn't sound good. You sound like you're in a 5-gallon jug. And that's annoying to me. I mean, that's annoying to me. I can't. Ah. I'm saying? And so it's a turn off. So, but a lot of guys today were playing freaking heavy metal shit. So one guy was playing something, and I'm like, wow, that reminds me of a song, and I can't remember the goddamn song. And so I'm like, was it Maiden? Because I remember I used to go to this club called Caffeine. It was something before Caffeine, but they got busted for selling drugs. And I used to go there because they didn't sell alcohol. And then I was clean, but I mean, I was still clean, like 26 years now. So, but I was clean then, so, and it was heavy metal. Well, it was all kinds of shit. It was trance, it was mosh pit type shit, and it was just loud, like freaking Don't Leave You Alone music loud. And that's what I needed at the time, because I was starting to get freaking, my peace of mind was getting freaking to me. So they used to play Maiden, Pantera, or, you know, and Bile and all kinds of freaking shit. And we used to get in the mosh pit, and it was the only time I felt like I could comfortably get into a mosh pit without getting the fucking living shit beat out of me. Because I am not a big guy. I'm like all of 5'8", so I'm like, you know. And these guys were big. Big. And you had to, you know, you had to be a little nuts to freaking jump in, you know. So, got a little nuts, you know, and used to get in there. And nobody used to get busted up too badly. I mean, and if you wound up on the ground, people would pick you up, you know. You know, like, not like other mosh pits where it's just like, you get your ass stomped if you wind up on the floor, man. And it's very easy to wind up on the floor. Because, like I said, these guys were fucking big. You just could wind up one side of the freaking pit to the other. And the next thing you know it, you're like on all fours. And forget about it, man. It's just, let's pile on the rabbit. I'm like, oh, shit. Next thing you know is you might as well have had the football. So, I don't know. So I'm listening to, watching the reviews, and I'm like, oh yeah. So that's why I was doing that thing. Now I can't play it, right? I played it earlier, and now I can't play it. I can't remember how it goes. So I looked up Number of the Beast, and I'm like, oh yeah, that's how it goes and shit like that. And I was like, that was it. And I because, you know, there was talking, and then, you know, the guy wound up freaking singing, and then, well, kind of like talking, singing, and then they started screaming. And I was like, yeah. That was it. Now I remember everything. I'm trying, Rob Baker. Got to do it slow, right? Got to do it. I was getting fast there for a while, but it was all hammering. And then the picking part, it was because I'm not doing it clean. And so you can't. Sounds like shit, you know. Sounds like you're going fast, but you're sloppy. And so I got to slow back down and start cleaning it up. It's part of the practice. I gotta pay the dues. Gotta pay your dues. So, I love this fucking thing. And so, the Marshall AVT-150H. Turns out it's a hybrid. I still didn't find a full freaking thing on it. I didn't really go crazy looking at going to websites, you know, and looking at the specs on them and everything like that. But it's got tubes, and it seems to be a freaking decent unit. I mean, if you're looking for something like that, budget conscious wise, you know, it seems to be freaking pretty badass, you know. I don't know if it's like recording ready, but from what I've seen so far, I mean, I could be wrong, because I haven't freaking played one, you know, I haven't played one yet. It has awesome sound. So, I mean, it has crazy digital effects. It looks like it has like four channels, or two channels, but like split. And a decent pedal. It's got overdrive 1 and overdrive 2, and then it also splits for acoustic sim and something else. But there's like four buttons on the goddamn thing on the pedal. Not bad. Not bad. So it was funny because I had saw. You ever see something and you're like, what? For how much? What? Because I saw something for like $250, and it was a Fender Blues, Fender Deluxe, not Deluxe. It was Hot Rod Deluxe. $250. I was like, get the fuck out of here. Sure enough, I go to take a look at it a little bit closer. It's the cabinet. It's the extended cabinet. It says it's 80 watt, but it's the freaking, it's just a 1x12 inside a freaking cabinet. I'm like, And then there's a shitload of, I'm like, oh, you got me. Like, oh, you got me. And I'm like, what would you get another one for? To be honest with you? To turn it into a freaking head, you know, to turn it into a head. I don't need another combo, but to turn it into a fucking head, that would be kind of cool. It's fucking hot in here now. Hot. So anyway, that's my two cents. I don't know what this is going to be called. But it is the 190th. I got 10 more videos. And like I said, this is my freaking anniversary. What is it? 3 days ago. 3 days ago last year, they gave me a second chance. And put in the Steve Austin $6 million man freaking thing. And it's a defibrillator and pacemaker at the same time, because my heart was over, it was deteriorating. So it enlarged, and then it was pretty much down the one fucking valve, and like 10 to 15%, between 10 and like 15 and 10% ejection fraction. So it was like, which means there wasn't a whole lot of squeeze. It pumped like fucking crazy, but there wasn't a whole lot of squeeze. There ain't a whole lot of pressure going on. So, which is freaking weird considering my blood pressure, well, it was low. It was like dead low. No pun intended. And they've gotten it up to about freaking 110. It's in and around 110 over 70, 68, you know, give or take. But it's like freaking. And my little one, she leans on my chest and she's just like, oh, it feels so fucking artificial. I can't. I'm like, oh, well. What are you gonna do? So, because it, my heart goes out of sync. So, it goes and it like it really freaking does a number when it goes out of sync. It reads it and recognizes that it's going out of sync because the valves just don't freaking, they don't all go at the same time. They start going galloping, you know. Brrrr. So, it syncs it up so that it increases the pressure. That's the deal with that. So, like I said, it's a year ago now. I'd have gotten out of the freaking hospital 2 days ago. 2 days ago. From Philadelphia. And they did right by me. They did okay. The transplant guy that I went down to freaking, you know, he's a fucking piece of work. You know, but I don't know. I guess he's kept me going because... For a while, it was like every two, three months, you know. It didn't matter what kind of pills they put me on. It was no fucking help. It was just... So... That in a nutshell, and I'm working on my way to get up to the freaking 200th, because I got 300 more freaking videos to do before I hit 500, and because that's when you freaking you get to the next plateau. So it's either that or freaking just be doing shit for like 2 years. I don't know. Whatever. I'm not looking for a whole freaking huge thing of freaking followers or whatever. Heavy duty channel or whatever. I don't have a lot of people on Fade to Black freaking watch this. You know, I do get involved with the group who listen and get together on Twitter. But if you're into like freaking alternative stuff and whatever, I would, you know, watch Fade to Black. Get involved with the freaking people there. They're kind of cool. You know? If you're not into it, you know, that's cool too. Peace. Have a good one. I can only go so far. I can't really push it too, and I'm already beyond, so thank you for your time. You've been oh so gracious, and as your humble host, I wish you all the best, and I will speak to you hopefully sometime after I catch some fucking rest, and all this good shit. The little one's back home, so he's sleeping soundly. I'm imagining that they will not be going either to work or to school tomorrow. So that'll be that. Right? So my best to y'all and Ripley. Love you, Ripley. Hopefully I'll be seeing you soon, doggy dog. And all that good shit along with the rest of my family. Right on. Peace.